Do you need to drill a perfectly straight hole, but you don't have a drill press? And freehand drilling is just not straight enough? Hi, I'm Aaron, and I'm going to go through what I think are the five best stupid easy ways of drilling a straight hole with a power drill. And we're going to do this without spending tons of money on a drill press or spending tons of time on crazy jigs. Now, if you think there's another dead simple way to drill a straight hole with a power drill that I should have made the list, then at the end, leave me a comment below. Using a straight edge as a guide. Now, you can use something like a speed square as a guide for your drill. This technique is okay and it's better than nothing, but this is my least favorite method. You have to try to keep it straight with the straight edge and also try not to let the drill move left or right. Now, I find the holes are straighter than freehanding and it's quick and dirty, but the results are not always as precise as could be. CD reflection. Now, if you've never heard of this, I know it sounds odd, but it does work. The idea of this is that you can see how the drill lines up reflected in the mirrored surface of the CD. Look straight down from above when you're drilling, and it will help visually guide you. It's a little weird at first, but if you do a couple of practice holes on some scrap, you'll find the results are actually not too shabby, and since everyone has an old CD laying around, it's friendly on the wallet. 90-degree wood scraps. Now, this one, you just join two pieces of scrap wood at a 90-degree angle to create a simple jig. I personally use one-by material and hold them together with a spring clamp. Then I just nestle my drill bit into the joint and use that to guide the drill. Now, this method is not just easy, but fairly reliable. And these jigs are super easy to make. You can put them together in minutes, and you can make them for any drill bit size. I've seen lots of variations on this theme, with some people gluing them or screwing them together for multiple uses. And occasionally, I've even seen people use metal to make them more durable. The drill block. Now, if you want a cheap, off-the-shelf solution, you could just buy a drill block for as little as $8. And to use it, just put it where you want to drill the hole and get to work. The accuracy is great, and I do love having this little block in my tool bag. And although you have to shell out a couple of bucks, it's quick, it's easy, and it works great. Another great advantage to a drill block is that it's the easiest tool to use vertically, horizontally, or just about any angle. Now, I've seen some complaints that the drill block stops you from drilling all the way through the wood with the bit. But I find once the hole is started, then the hole itself becomes the guide for the drill bit, so you can continue drilling straight. Another possible con is that you are limited by the drill bit size that are part of the drill block. But don't worry, there are lots of options for drill blocks that will accommodate a number of different bit sizes. Portable drill guide. Okay, this one is cheating a little bit because it's really just a mini version of a full drill press, but if you need really straight holes, then this is a pretty good tool. Now, I find that often I don't even need to clamp it, but you can secure it with clamps, screws, or even both if you need to. It's a little more clumsy than a drill press, but it works and the accuracy is really good. And because it's portable, you can use it for drilling at odd angles a drill press would never be able to do. Now, these portable drill guides start a little over $30-ish, which is way less than the hundreds of dollars a full drill press would run you. So these are my go-to methods for drilling straight holes. Let me know in the comments which method works best for you. And be sure to check out this video. YouTube thinks you might like it. Thanks for watching.